If you don't know this song, and you probably should, it's Brook and Jubal in the Morning. It's the theme song for the movie franchise that's arguably one of the biggest ones to ever hit the silver screen. In fact, its latest installment already made $140 million in less than a week.
Wow.
I'm talking about Toy Story 4. But some film critics say they expected it to do better, and parts of the actual film don't live up to all the hype. Well, I'm sure most of those idiot movie reviewers were sober when they saw it. And maybe that's the problem. Things are always better when you got beer goggles on.
Duh. Yeah, especially when you're going to see a children's movie.
Yeah.
That totally makes sense.
That's screenshots.
Yeah. That's why we had our own resident movie critic, Jose Bolanos, get extremely liquored up and then head over to the local cinema for another drunk movie review.
Yes.
And this movie review, from what producer Boyd tells me, was a little bit different because you were feeling a bit under the weather. Before you got drunk for it.
I had like the worst week ever. I partied super hard the end of last week. Then I got sick for like 2 days.
Oh, I wonder why.
And then, thank you.
Yeah.
And then,
man,
they're like, the review's here. You can't reschedule it.
Right.
So they suggested, hey, just don't like drink before maybe. Like, because sometimes I sneak it in. I'm not supposed to say that. But so maybe just drink a little during. You know, we don't want you to like start throwing up again.
Right.
I finally stopped. And I tricked Jeff, and I took plenty of shots.
All right.
Okay,
so you're already hammered way before you got
and
there.
And then another shot, and then Jeffrey's like an hour away, and I'm like, I'm getting drunk, dude.
Right, so Jeff showed up, because Jeff always accompanies you with the drunk movie reviews, and he showed up, and you were already hammered.
Yes.
That must have been fun for you, Jeff.
Yep.
He's standing in the back of the room. Yeah, he's defeated already from just having to hang out with you.
It's this movie, the theater, is all children, right? And their families.
Oh,
so
it was all kids.
Yeah, including you.
Were you nervous?
No, I was drunk. I felt great.
Yeah.
You're
no nervous.
You're that creepy guy.
You were excited.
All right.
Before doing this, are you a fan of the Toy Story franchise?
I mean, I'm a fan. I'm a casual fan, though. I've seen the first one and I think the second one.
All right.
Not the third one.
The third one's the best one.
See, I don't really know what's going on.
Okay,
storyline mode.
You're not super passionate about it. But I'm sure you were super passionate about it while you were drunk. So why don't we listen into the first clip of Jose's drunk movie review when he attempts to tell us the plot of Toy Story 4.
The plot of Toy Story 4 is adventure and action and romance a little bit, which you wouldn't think is a big deal, but it hits you in the heart, dude. Like, I never wanted toys to hook up more than I've ever seen this movie. Like, I was like, toys, 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 do it. Like, I mean, you know what I mean? It's a kid's movie, but there's chemistry. And there's a new guy, his name's Forky, and I love Forky, because he's like the cutest toy. I don't want to give too much away, but I will say I relate to Forky, because the fork is also my best friend. I love food, Jeff. And this child, she turned a fork into a toy, and I was like, oh my god, I did that already. Like, it's just the same thing. It's like I'm playing a game with the toy. I'm like, hi, Forky. Let's play dim sum. Let's play ramen. It's fun. It's hot for you. Tastes good for me. Sorry.
Yes. Okay. So far, we know Toy Story 4 is oozing with sex. And then also, you really liked it because of the fork reminding you of food.
Yeah, absolutely. You guys know me. Throughout the whole show, I'm pretty much watching food bloggers and food videos. Forks are my favorite. I love chopsticks, too.
Anything that handles food is good.
Absolutely.
Even your hands sometimes.
A knife, whatever it is. And I will say, toys doing it, as a child, I made that happen a lot, too.
Yeah.
So that is not just an adult thing.
I think that's
like,
pretty common.
If you ever played with Barbies, they were definitely doing it.
Any toy. You just wanted to see some hot toy-on-toy action.
I'm going to tell you,
my
Barbies did a lot more than kissing.
Oh, God. Okay.
That's probably one of the most accurate plot lines you've ever given, though.
Yeah.
As far as a drunk movie review goes.
It has to be a plot line that a child can understand. So it makes sense that he can follow this one. Yeah.
Well, based on the earlier commentary, you might assume that Forky might be Jose's favorite character. But I guess you'd be wrong.
Forky is not my favorite character. He's very close second. Who's my favorite character? T-Rex. Because he's so much like me, dude. He is happy all the time. He's like, guys, what are we doing? What's going on? Okay, I'm part of the plan. Yay. But then, like, he has the worst anxiety in the world.
Yeah.
It's like me. I'm scared of everything. And everything we do, I get panic attacks. How many times a week do I come into the booth and I beg you for emotional support because I'm having a panic attack? Because I'm a dinosaur, dog. That's the thing, dude. We have small brains. We're happy. And we both have a severe anxiety. Is it time for another shot? Because you're stressing me out, dude. All these questions are... Honestly, dude, I'm going to have a dinosaur anxiety attack.
A dinosaur anxiety attack. You know what? I've never really seen the Toy Story movies, but I have seen clips of that dinosaur.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Dude.
It's you. As soon as you said it, I was like, oh, that is Jose.
And that is the most self-aware thing you have ever said in your entire life.
It's true.
Yeah. If you've ever wondered what Jose is like in real life, he's like the T-Rex from Toy Story.
I'm watching the movie and he's like, okay, guys, I'm excited. And I'm also excited. Yeah. Like, he's reading my mind.
And he's got a funny laugh and everything.
Yeah, he does.
Drunk Movie Reviews with Jose Bolaños. And today we're listening to him review the animated blockbuster Toy Story 4. So it's obvious that he likes a lot of the characters and toys in the movie. But was there anything about Toy Story 4 that Jose didn't like? Let's find out.
So here's the thing. There's one thing that annoyed me so much is they still have Randy Newman as the intro song. The You Got a Friend in Me song. And here's the thing about Randy Newman. If you talk to him in real life, it's like, hi, I'm Randy Newman. Nice to meet you. He sounds like a normal guy, right? The second this guy starts singing, it's like, man, you got a friend in me. You got a friend in me. And I'm confused. That voice doesn't make me want to play with toys. It's creepy. Is Justin Bieber back there somewhere? Can I get Rihanna? Maybe. You know, you got a friend in me, you know, something cool, dude. Like maybe DJ Marshmello. It'd be like, you got a friend. Oh, here comes the drop. Bum, 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 bum. Put it up. Bum, bum, bum. You got a friend. You got a friend. We would play that on this station.
I think you were drunk and you were just wanted to party. You heard music and you're like, why isn't this music I can dance to? But I also agree with you. I wish that the theme to Toy Story had more swearing in it. Like, a little bit more.
That was a horrible Randy Newman impression, by the way.
That was so bad. Okay, but spot on
sort of like a Cookie Monster
hybrid.
Yeah, Louis Armstrong, Randy Newman, Cookie Monster hybrid.
Uh-huh.
But I do think DJ Marshmello should do the next one if they do Toy Story 5. Add more swearing.
Yeah!
All right, we'll hear more from Jose in his drunk movie review of Toy Story 4, including why he got emotional during the screening, plus his final rating right after this. It's Brooke and Jubal in the morning.
This is the first time in my life I saw a toy and I was attracted to it. And her name was Bo. I don't want to give it up. But she's hot, dude. That's a hot toy. She had beautiful eyes. Just huge, pretty eyes and her hair. And her smile. Super sexy toy. I was like, bounce. Bang, bang, chicka, chicka, bang, bang, chicka, sexy toy. You know what I mean?
Wouldn't be a drunk movie review with Jose Bolanos if he wasn't hitting on one of the characters. And today, Jose is reviewing the new movie Toy Story 4. And so far, we've learned that Jose believes his best friend is a fork.
Uh-huh.
Yes.
Not only because there's a fork character on the new movie, but he also just really likes forks a lot because they give him food. And he wouldn't be opposed to a few toys hooking up. In fact, he just told us that little Bo Peep gets his juices flowing.
She was very attractive. I don't want to say that aggressively now, but she was cute.
I am very impressed you didn't mention her boobs or her butt.
I did not. Well, you couldn't see him. I was trying to look, but she has a big puffy dress on.
Yeah, right.
So I can't compare when I can't
see it. She's teasing you.
Yeah,
okay.
There you go.
I see. What's under the dress, Bo?
Well, exactly. It's not done yet. There might be something in there. Shockingly, that's not the only weird thing that happened during the screening. Let's hear Jose talk about the strangest part of the night for him.
the weirdest thing that happened to me in the movie, which nothing weird ever happens during these movies, but there's a point in the movie where I'm so happy because there's so many cool things happening with all the toys, and I love toys. And not thinking, I put my thumb in my mouth. I'm sucking my thumb. I'm having a great time. And I look to my right, and there's a 9-year-old girl in a princess dress. She's also sucking her thumb. And at this moment, I'm like, me and this child are sucking our thumbs together, enjoying the same moment. At the same time, I'm twirling my hair and sucking my thumb, and I'm having the time of my life, Jeff. And so is she. I don't know her name. I never met her, but she's the cutest little blonde girl. And her and I are both princesses at this one moment, watching Toy Story 4 and just thinking, God, this is the life.
Oh my
that
God.
Was oddly beautiful.
Thank
like,
you.
Really, I kind of want to make fun of the experience, but I'm putting myself in your shoes, and I'm like, if I was watching this movie drunk, sucking my thumb, just, and I looked over, and there was someone else just twirling their hair, sucking their thumb,
give
too, and
nod.
We shared a moment, just like, yeah, man, this is living. I can't hate on that.
And the funny thing is, you do suck your thumb.
Yeah, it's
you
a tendency. I like, put it in my mouth, I don't think about it. No.
Now, I'll look over when you're working, and you'll do it the adult style. Well, you'll keep your mouth open,
yeah.
But you'll have your thumb in your mouth pushing on the roof of your
yes,
mouth. And that's the adult version of Jose sucking his
and
thumb.
And I twirl my hair nonstop. You guys see my right. hair is always, there's always like, looks like there's dreadlocks on it.
All I know is I just needed, tick. I needed some sort of feel-good story today, and that's it. Just the way that you bonded during that film.
Thank you. I'm a 9-year-old child.
Yes. I have
you.
A feeling that the 9-year-old girl didn't feel as much like love towards you. If she
know,
looked
she...
over, she probably would have been like, "Mommy,
this grown yeah. man is
I'm scared.
Yeah. I think copying me."
Yeah.
It's Drunk Movie Reviews with Jose Bolanos, and today we're listening to him review the animated blockbuster Toy Story 4. While Jose was analyzing the film, he came to a realization about himself. Not that he's a 9-year-old girl. Another realization. Let's hear what that is.
I felt like in Toy Story 4, there was a love story. And toys do fall in love, dude. I believe in toy love. You know, when a girl or a boy picks up a man toy and a boy toy, or a boy toy and another boy toy, or a girl toy and a girl toy, and they kiss and they go, "Hey, we're playing doctor. I'm the nurse. You're the doctor. You're pretty. I'm pretty." Right? I've done that, dude. I've made toys kiss when I was a child, dude. My Power Rangers toys kiss. And there was Ken and Barbie. They always kiss. And then there was Bert and Ernie, which they weren't supposed to kiss. And my parents had to talk with me, but later on it was cool. And you know what I realized? In this movie, Toy Story 4, toys are exactly like me, Jeffrey. All I want is a child to love me, dude.
Wait a minute.
Not a weird way. You keep laughing. Don't. I want to hug him and kiss him. Not a weird way. I'm just like, hey, I was a kid. You're a kid. I love Toy Story. You love Toy Story. Give me a hug. It's not weird.
Yeah, I take back everything I just said about that beautiful moment you shared with that kid. That's all
that.
I needed to hear was, I just want a child to love me.
Well, I'm a child at heart.
Here's the thing.
I'm trying to.
That would have been fine if the lead up wasn't you reliving making your doctor and nurse toy do
yeah.
it. Like,
you already said we've all done that. You can't judge me on it.
Yeah, but I don't put it together with me loving a child is
yeah.
a thing.
I don't think I said that right. I think I'm a child at heart and
uh-huh.
I want to find
uh-huh.
love. Just
right.
like a child wants their dolls to find love.
I'm waiting for
again.
The HBO documentary Finding
yeah.
Toy Story to come out now. Starring Jose Bolanos. Yeah.
And my kids won't be coming to the studio anytime
oh,
soon.
Oh, come on!
So.
Your kids are safe around me.
Yeah, that's what they say. That's what people who like children say. Now
oh God.
That the police are officially probably on their way to the building, we only have a few minutes left to get Jose's final rating, so let's hope this isn't worse than the last clip.
There nothing can be.
All right, Jeff, this is a bold rating that I don't think I've ever given, ever. Toy Story 4 is 4 toys out of 4 stories. See what I did there? It's 100% perfect. It's a perfectly put together film. There's sadness, there's happiness, there's cryingness. I cried a lot. And I think every person can relate to having a favorite toy. Because, like, I used to have so many. I used to have an old white Power Ranger, and I never found you, but I miss you. And if you're listening right now, you remember what we used to do together. You remember we had our own thing. You remember after we win a game? You remember the kiss. It was a stupid kiss, but you would always do it. And I'd put chapstick on your mouth. You remember? I would really put lipstick on it or chapstick on him. And we would kiss. I was young, Jeff. I was 12. All right, you guys. I hope you don't air this part. I'm Jose.
Yeah.
It's been Brooke and Jubal in the morning. Why'd you let me keep talking?
Yeah. You weren't drunk enough to know that you shouldn't have been talking. 12 years old and you're putting chapstick on your Power Ranger and making out with it.
Playing video games.
Uh-huh.
Haven't had a kiss yet.
Yeah. 12 is like junior high, dude.
Yeah, and I was a late bloomer, Brooke. And so I didn't know the feel of what chapstick felt like against her lips when you're
right.
kissing someone.
But you missed that feeling of the Power Ranger's lips against yours.
That's probably why he ran away.
Maybe that's the problem with the relationship issues, you know, that you have. Nobody can ever match up to the Power Ranger. And you didn't realize that until now.
Yeah.
You're just searching for your Power Ranger.
Yeah, well, I think I should see myself out.
Or a therapist. Yeah. I think you should see a therapist after today's drunk movie review.
Oh, I was really excited for Toy Story 4, and now I'm just disturbed by who you are.
Yeah.
Text in 78592.
So much kissing.
What'd you think of Jose's drunk movie review?
Wow.
And don't be honest. Just say you liked it.
Thank you.
You're
so
welcome.
Much.